Good evening, YouTube. This is Silent Citadel, and tonight I'd like to share a craft with you. For this project, you're going to need magnets, scissors, glue, card, and nail polish. You can use regular paint, but I think this is a great way to use extra nail polish. I don't know if any of you are like me, but I find that when I buy nail polish, I'll use it a couple times, and then in a fairly short period of time, the polish will get old and sticky, or you just find you don't use the color very much. And it's a shame to let it all go to waste. So this is a great way to use all your extra polishes rather than letting them molder in some bathroom cabinet or makeup box. You'll also need little decorative half marbles. These are available pretty much anywhere. Craft stores, online, very easy to come by, and very inexpensive. Lastly, pen. Any pen will do. The first step is to take a magnet, place it on the paper, draw a little circle around it. Next, we're going to go ahead and cut out our little circle here, and it's good to cut inside the line, because you want it just a little smaller, than the circle that you've drawn. So just try and leave that pen mark. It doesn't have to be perfect. Out like this. My little circle here. I've got a few of these that I've cut out. So now we're going to go ahead and select a polish. You can choose as many or as few as you like for anyone. I'm gonna go ahead and go this blue. I don't use this blue very much. It's a nice color. This is Flying High by China Glaze. Taking the cap of the pen, going to hold my little circle down. I want to do this on a surface. It doesn't matter if it gets paint on it. I'm using an old towel. But anything will do. It's can get messy. If you have a craft sheet or some old newspaper, whatever works. We go. Got my little blue circle. I'm going to take some of this. This is one of my favorite polishes. It's called Blue Eyed Girl by Clean Color. I love this polish, but it's already getting a little sticky. Tell it's not gonna last long. Go ahead and just kind of glob some of that on there. Not even all the way. Just cover a part of it. Set this one out of the way. Another. This one I'm going to use is this great glitter balm called Electrify. And this was one of the polishes that was released with the first Hunger Games movie. Very, very sparkly. It's really flashy. Pretty fun. It's not totally opaque, but it's gonna kind of dollop a little bit more on there. Do we get a nice coverage? Unlike your nails, you don't have to worry about keeping it too even or doing multiple coats. So when you get one of these, it's dry. We're going to go ahead and, once it's dry, we're going to go ahead and just put the not dry, pardon me, tacky. Put the marble on top of it. So it kind of squishes it down a little bit. And the nail polish is still sticky, so it will adhere very nicely. Just give it a few seconds. Put right on there. Okay. I'm gonna do a few more of these. Let's choose this green. This is Did It On Them. It's another. It's an OPI polish. On this one, I'm going to go ahead and add some of this. This is a green glitter polish called Chunky Hollow Clover. And I've never actually even worn this. I just really like the way it looked in the bottle. kind of put some edges on this side. Just a little. Set that one over there. One I'm going to use hard candy beetle. Yes. I don't know if you can hear that. I hear a train. Never been able to figure out where the tracks are, but I always hear it. It's kind of nice. Makes me wonder where these people are going, that the train's carrying. Beautiful purple is called Flying Dragon. It's another china glaze. I'm gonna throw some top coat. This is a hard candy glitter top coat. I'm just gonna add a little. Some sparkle. These little magnets make great gifts. They're small, but handmade. Who doesn't love a good handmade gift? They're also very easy. They don't require a lot of artistic skill. Just too much nail polish. Now, if you want to do a drawn-on pattern, you can, but you'll have to use either glue or a clear top coat to cover it and put between. Your marble in the paper. I've tried using pictures and whatnot, but I find that any top coat tends to darken or smear the image a little. often, so I really like using the polishes, partially because I have a lot of them. I'll buy a color because it appeals to me, because I like the way it looks in the bottle. But sometimes I don't even really want to wear that color. I just like to look at it. So I've made a few more. This one's got little stars. This one is silver and black. This one's a nice deep sort of blood red. The sparkly black and purple. I want to wait for this to dry. These magnets are available for very cheap on eBay. Craft stores or even general good stores. My local Fred Meyer sells these. They're very inexpensive. Just take one. Super glue on it. Wait for a minute. And there you go. So easy. Like I said, it doesn't really take any real artistic skill. Just a little time. A little effort. Some very basic supplies. Now, if you don't have nail polish because you don't wear it, or whatever reason, you can use a regular acrylic paints. And I like polishes because flashy. They have very bright colors that really pop. They tend to be very inexpensive. And they also are very good at adhering the glass marbles to the paper. Whereas if you were using regular paint, you might have to use a glue or some other kind of intermediate medium to attach the two aspects together. So, I'm going to let these sit out overnight, and the polish is pretty much dry on them, but I'm going to give it time to completely set, because if you try and play with them, if they have any amount of tackiness left, they will come separated. It's important to give each of them plenty of space between so that they don't bolt together, as magnets like to do. So we'll just wait. Let these dry. I hope all of you have a very prosperous and happy new year. I really enjoyed this last year with all of you. Some have had better years than others, but for all of us and all of you, I wish the happiest days ahead. And I thank you so much for tuning in to my strange little channel. Your comments, suggestions, and love make this entire endeavor possible. We couldn't do it without all of you. So, thank you again. Have a beautiful evening.